Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to welcome you to the InterCity Athletic 6th Annual Central Mechanic Arts Women's Alumni Game.
Six?
And to my immediate left is my colleague, Mr. Timmy Simmons. He'll be doing the play-by-play as we go along today in the game. And Timmy.
Yes.
It's the 6th annual, but Central has they haven't won a game yet. What do they need to do this year?
Oh, man. Central just needs to bring it. I don't know. Mechanic Arts, man. Central was doing it good last year. But I'm seeing now the big girl's not here. So that really didn't hurt them. So now they got to get out and run.
Which benefits
Mechanic Arts. So Central just got to let it loose, man, and just let it fly.
Well, Central's got a pretty small, looks like a quick team out there. They got Johnson, Neil Johnson, and Amber Neil.
Yeah, but you look at Mechanic Arts lineup out there. Jessica, Teresa, woo.
Well, they got more disciplined team.
Man, and they play together, too.
Right, that's right, bro.
You know, I give these ladies credit, because these ladies be down at Oxford, Jimmy Lee, playing ball every Sunday afternoon, Saturday or Sunday afternoon.
And there goes the tip. It's controlled by the trainers.
Teresa Litters, she told me she's going to give 10 points at least.
Only 10, huh?
Well, hey, remember last year what she did?
Barnes the three, and she kisses it off the glass.
Off the glass. She starts it out already. And that's the one I talk about. She was a threat last year when she came back and helped Mechanic Arts win this one.
Amber Neal with the shot. She comes up short. Newell with the big rebound.
Jessica Williams is another threat out here, too.
Well, they're just setting it up, passing it back and forth. Kicks it over to Barnes. Over to Sheldon. She takes a shot. A little short. Neil Johnson with the quick pass up the court to Pollard. Good defense.
Oh. Hey, I'm seeing a difference. Remember last year with Pollard? You know, Pollard was a little aggressive last year. Looks like she got some legs under it this year. So it could be a problem for Mechanic Arts.
So the foul goes on Selena Barnes. That's her first. She'll be shooting two.
Hey, you know what's good about this game here with these ladies that ranges from, you know, 20 to, you know, veterans. I call them veterans.
Okay.
That they're still out here running and they're still out here doing their thing. And that's a good thing for the ladies' sport.
And Pollard knocks down the second shot. 3-1, Mechanics. Williams walks it up slowly for the ladies.
Audrey and Amber, they got to bring it too.
Kicks it into Barnes. She takes another three. She's way off. Air ball.
That's one you got to say. Four.
Johnson pass at the court. Amber's trying to run it down. She can't get to it. Turnover Central.
Jessica Williams.
Williams back to Sheldon. She gets up and down, up and down.
Oh, that's a technical foul. That's the fun about this game, too, to see the ladies have a good time.
Here's that last play again. Well, we lost it. Back to live action. Nice save by Pollard. And we got a jump ball.
Good hustle, ladies. Good hustle. That's what we want to see. The ladies getting on the floor, letting them know.
Oh, no. Possession, Central. Pollard kicks it into Neil Johnson.
So you think this is a good tactic for Central to slow it down a little bit?
Well, someone's got to get open, though. Get a good shot like that. Johnson with the three.
Oh, nothing but net.
That's right. There was a good shot.
Nothing but net.
Aubrey Johnson with the big three to put the ladies back on top for Central. 4-3. Sheldon with another attempt.
Uh-oh. She's building houses.
Barnes kicks it out.
In case y'all don't understand about building houses, I meant she shot a brick.
I heard that. Another long three-point attempt. You know, I think sometimes when you hit that first three, it gives you a false sense of confidence, and they just keep on shooting them. They haven't hit one since then. They've taken five shots from the three-point range. Barnes brings it up through the nice pass between the legs to Williams. Kicks it back in to Little Smith. And she passes it out. Oh, another missed shot.
I had to give that Harlem Globetrotter move, the theme song right there, but now. A little trickery by the ladies.
We got a substitution coming in.
Good hustle, Sheldon.
All right, Sheldon goes out, Dennings. Dennings comes in for the trainers.
Come in, shoot.
Cross court pass.
Another one.
It was Barnes taking it to the hole. Looking for a call from the referee, but she didn't get it. Boy, she gave him the stink eye.
Hey, what was that one? Without dribbling, she got the half court, huh?
Central sets it up. Jones, nice little move, but she's thwarted in her attempt for a layup.
Referees are letting them play today, hon.
Pollard takes it in the hole. Oh, she comes up short.
Well, that was a short arm hook, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. She called a baby hook. Down court pass to Dimmings.
Uh-oh.
They got numbers. Oh, whoa. Nice pass inside, but.
You know, that's one thing that I do like about the Mechanic Arts team, how they do move that ball, how unselfish they play.
Teresa Little Smith was fouled on at layup attempt. She'll be shooting two. She'll be trying to tie up the contest right now.
Teresa Little. You know, they're starting out slow. And I'm going to tell you, just like last year, remember how slow we started out.
That's like the third shot that just rimmed out. They got them too tight, maybe. Wound up too tight.
I'm looking for Central to up it up now. We got a couple runners up in there now.
And we got, in and out again. There's that play again inside the Little Smith.
Good pass.
There it is. And she's fouled.
I don't know. I got to talk to the refs on that one. Johnson.
She's coming up short, though. Well, if Central wants to stay in this game, they need to hit the boards. When someone takes a shot, someone's got to come from the other side and hit the boards. They are getting killed on the rebounds.
Suggs.
That's Suggs with the big basket.
She could be a factor in this game, too.
Neil Johnson.
Fires on the D.
Pass over to the other Johnson.
Oh, they're in the zone. Kanakachi is playing the zone. What do you do against the zone? Move the ball. Yep. Move it. Swing it.
Walsh with the ball.
There you go.
Gustafson. And she takes a long shot. She misses.
That was good swinging the ball, though.
Kick it inside of Dennings.
Oh, good move, Dennings.
And she's got no shot.
And we're in the bottom of the third. Score 5-4.
Here's that foul play again. Well, a long three-shot attempt by the trainers again, and they come up short. Nice steal by Dennings.
Hit the first one.
They can't buy a basket now from three-point land. Oh, there was the pass. There was the pass. And she.
They won something. Oh,
they got the ball back. They got the ball back. Barnes brings it up. Kicks it back to Williams. Williams the long three, and it comes up short. Pam Brunell with
good steal.
Pass.
Good, no look. Uh-oh. I think that was a pre-whistle he did.
Is that foul or what?
He caught a foul on Johnson.
Run that back on the videotape. Let's see what's going on here. Oh, I don't know about that.
Yeah. Might have to talk to the officiating association on that guy.
Demings with the first attempt. And in and out.
What's going on with the free throws? Hey. So who, this type of game, who does it favor more, Bernard?
Well, if you go look at the records, you'd have to say Mechanics.
Yeah.
But if Central could get something going.
Yes.
If. But there's a big turnover. Walsh throws it to Barnes, straight to her, trying to do a cross-court pass.
And Suggs was asking for that one, too.
Central gets it back. Gustafson brings it up. She's looking for her. And another shot comes up short.
Hemmings.
Now, she's new this year, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
Well, she faked herself out on that.
I think
crossover
she
dribble.
She hurts a fingernail too.
Oh, okay. Well, the turnover by the Lady Trainers. Central brings it in. We're at the 9:50 mark, and it's a 5-4 game. The Trainers up over the ladies from Central. Cross court pass, and she throws it out of bounds.
She looked at that like, am I supposed to go get that?
You got to jump for those.
Hey, I can only get up so high. But she would have caught that one. I would have said, oh, she's dunking. She's dunking.
You know what's a misleading stat here in this game so far is that Central shoot has a better shooting percentage so far in this game, and they're losing. Go figure.
So what do we have here?
I thought she's gonna knock that one down.
We have three field goals made in this game.
Littles Butler. Two.
Pollard.
Whoa, well, Pollard comes up short. She got a hit on the arm, but no call there.
Somebody has to wake up. Pollard said, I'm trying.
Well, they would kick it back to the side. You know, they always have someone open on this, on the left side of the court for Central, but they don't see that person. Littles Butler controls the ball, kicks over to Demings. She does a little dribble and a dance with it. Suggs with the long three.
Ooh. Ooh. Caught a double dribble.
Oh, my goodness. Somebody needs to break the scoring drought.
Yes. It's the first half jitters. It's the first half jitters we have for both teams.
Good block. Good block by Johnson.
There's it out. Uh-oh, Central got numbers.
Got the numbers three. Oh, and she throws it back to high back pass, and she throws it away. Three on one, and they couldn't take advantage of it.
You know, sometimes.
That is not good.
Sometimes just that basic pass.
Thank you.
Sometimes just that basic pass. Moving the ball. Look how Mechanicus is moving the ball.
But they're not getting the basket. Good save.
Who's this Newell? Is she new?
Whoa, Suggs off the glass.
She has came in and gave him a spark. Suggs has their last 4 points.
All right, 7-4 now, Mechanics. Central needs a basket for a confidence booster here.
Yes. Uh-oh.
Try to force a shot in on the pass inside. Walsh comes over, tries to steal it, but it's not working.
Got it. Said, I'll pull it. Another.
Oh, Central loses it out of bounds.
Gave the ball back to Central.
Here we go with the replay. But we're back to live action here.
Central needs a shot made. Not just a shot, but a made shot. Too many turnovers.
And they turn over again. Will the trainers take advantage of that turnover? Sucks kicks it out to Little. And Little drops one down. It's a two. They increase the lead to 5, 9-4 with 5:44 left in the first half.
And we better get a T.O.
I don't know what they need to do over there, but I don't know why they're throwing it inside. They don't have the size for that.
No,
just kick that ball around the perimeter. Keep throwing it back and forth. Someone's going to be open.
You know, my take on it is Central got the runners out there, but they're walking. You know, and to me, that would benefit them pushing up the ball.
Oh, that's true. They practically just wear them out. But.
And the coach is over explaining, hey, y'all got to spread it out and bring them in. What's going on there?
Well, they got to do something. I don't know. The coach is running faster, walking faster than they're running. So I don't know what's going on there.
And like you said, a slow game benefits the training.
That's right. They got the size. They're not going to beat them on the boards.
No.
There's no way.
Central, with the lineup they got in right now, they must utilize their quickness. They must. Gustafson, she has to get it going.
All right. Gustafson brings it back up.
Her and Walsh.
She kicks it over to Walsh.
But you look at Mechanic Arts, they're playing a 1-2-2 zone.
Well, they're denying them any kind. There's a shot right there. And it rims out. Good shot by Johnson. It was a good look.
Yes, it was.
But it didn't fall.
That might spark it up a little bit now. Let's get a little more aggressive, ladies. Let's go.
All right. Suggs kicks it into Byron. She brings it up.
Nope. Good defense. Push it.
Nice tap by Gustafson to deny Little Smith that basket, the ball. Suggs with the rebound.
Central short arming a lot of their shots. Easy shots at that.
Yeah, they're not following through with that shot. You can see at their release point.
And I'm going to tell you, Mechanic Arts, known for their 3-point shooting.
Barnes kicks it back out to Williams.
As she lets one fly.
There she
is. As I speak on it.
Don't let her get hot. Williams with the big three.
As I speak on it.
She rained on him last year.
Oh, man.
Like you wouldn't believe. Johnson kicks it back over to Gustafson. Back to Johnson.
There you go.
And the trainers control the rebound. Is that three again? But Jessica Williams, and just left at the bottom of the net. And Barnes lets one fly, but she comes up a little short. Oh, Johnson telling her to get off of her. He got numbers. Pass it there. There it is.
There we go. We ended the drought.
And Central gets their 6 point at 3:52 in the first half. 12-6, trainers.
Don't let her go.
Uncontested layup coming up.
Good hustle, Gustafson.
Gustafson, good hustle. Good hustle, real good hustle. She just took it back. Here's that play again.
Tina Jones goes in hard.
Yes, she did. All right, Gustafson will be shooting two.
You know, you look at this game. 6 points. Mechanic Arts is winning by 6 points. And either team can be up by 10.
One shot on the release.
Well, I think right now Central would just like to get to 10. Nice. It fell down. There you go. She kept the lead to 5-12-7 with 2:38 left in the first half. The trainers are in control of this ball game so far.
Central Dow is in a zone.
Fade away.
Oh, Newell.
Newell comes in and just makes her presence felt. 14-7, the trainers. Pollard takes it in and comes up. She misfired on that one.
Pollard hasn't been shy this first half. Well, she done put up.
Is that last play again?
Nice Newell. Warm, nice.
And another missed shot by the trainers. Walsh walks it up. Neil Johnson, she's thinking about it. And she shot and missed. All right, 1:38 left in the first half. And we have Barnes.
Number five.
Kicks it over to Little Smith. Back to Barnes.
I'm just impressed with the way
Barnes looking for a pick. Little dribbling exhibition by Barnes and Deming. In the paint.
Where's the foul call?
And here comes Walsh. Walsh is looking for someone who's open, but she might have to take the shot herself. Gustafson comes up. But Walsh is there to bail her out the rebound.
Sancho is out of sync this half. Try it again.
There she goes. Hit this one. That one's falling in. Here's that last play again. Deming's with the strong move in the paint. Deming's again. She's thought about it.
Uh-oh.
Williams with the miss. Central will probably get the last shot of the half. In and out
on her. A little bit too much English.
Number five.
Wow, the trainers. Mechanic Arts can set up for the last shot.
5 seconds left.
And it's a long.
And it comes up short. And with the trainers well in control of this game, 16-10 at the half.
That ain't well in control to me.
Well, until you start making stops and making baskets, yeah, I would say they're in control.
Oh, yeah, right. Okay, I got it. Once again, I tried to disagree to come back to agree with you.
Well, hey.
I'm just trying to battle this one out.
I'm not trying to argue the point, but hey.
And as we are with a very exciting first half, Central. Well,
ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank our sponsors for today's broadcast. We have the Mechanic Arts M Club, the Ellis Enterprise Web Development, EAB Distribution Company, Butterfly for Life, Sweet Inspiration, Heart to Heart Transportation, Golden Time Coffee and Cafe, Big Daddy's Barbecue, Booker Construction, African American Comforts, Arnello's Bar and Grill, and ASANDC.
Brotherhood Coffee, Twin City Radio Network, St. Albans COGIC, Community Stabilization Project, Brooks Funeral Home, Selby Wine and Spirits, Willard's Bar and Grill, The Men of March, McLemore Construction, Johnny Baby's Bar, Soul Touch Productions, and Fabulous Ferns.
And to round it out, we have the Rondo Avenue Incorporated, Sheer Pleasure Salon of Beauty, Celestial Touch, Best Steakhouse, Coolidge Trucking, Mancini's, the Hickory Hut, Subway, Perkins, and the Old Country Buffet.
Hey, man, you know which one I like. I like Big Daddy's barbecue.
Well, back to the game. You know what? They need to get close with the shot, Central, and make a run there, because them three-point shots, they ain't helping them.
For either team. I mean, if you look at it, Mechanic Arts has 2 3-pointers.
Yeah, they got two.
But the scariest thing is Mechanic Arts can come out and just start drilling threes at any time. And I'm looking at what Central's doing, and Central needs to find their identity for the second half.
And as far as the second half goes, like, they took a lot of threes, Mechanics. Jessica Williams, you know, once she gets her touch going, they're in trouble.
Oh, yes.
You know, don't let her get, you know, if she keeps on, let her keep on shooting it, but put a hand in her face, you know, just to try to throw her shot off some.
Yep. So as we do our halftime highlights, make sure you enjoy the second half of the 6th annual Ladies Mechanic Arts Central Alumni Game. Tina Jackson, she does a lot of dance line around the city of St. Paul. So this should be entertaining.
Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Come on, give it up.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we get ready to start the second half here with the Trainers with a 6-point lead, 16 to 10. Well, Tim, like I said before we went to the break, they need a lot of work. They need some stops, and they need to go to the free throw line. I think that's the only way they're going to get back in this game.
Central better get mad. That's what they better get mad and just get more aggressive.
All right. Well, here we go. Start the second half. Byron starts it off. Like she started the first half with the big three. 9-point lead, 19 to 10.
Sure.
Jones with it. Newell got her in the body there. That's like a foul.
You know, you look at the difference. Look at Mechanic Arts. And look at Central's body language.
Well, on that play right there, when she went up the lane, she had a man open to her left. She should have dumped it off to her. There was a shot.
And that's the difference what Mechanic Arts is doing. They're moving that ball around.
Barnes again. She's on FIRE.
What did we say?
22 to 10. 12-point advantage. That quick.
What did we say? Mechanic Arts can hit them threes.
Amber Neal being pressured by Barnes. Back to Jones. Gustafson, she takes a shot. And it rolls off.
Just can't get nothing to fall for him. Rebound Barnes.
Williams brings it up. Oh, Barnes being pressed. Good defense there by Johnson.
Where's the hot hand? Look how they move the ball around. Very unselfish. There's the hot hand. There's the hot hand.
Barnes with the third three of the game.
Look at Shelton.
But you know what? All right. Johnson plays are pretty tough, but she gave her too much space. Just stay with, you know. Be in there like a cheap suit.
Look how Mechanic Arts is finding, moving the ball around and finding the hot hand. Big difference.
Jones loses her dribble and ends up losing the ball. Newell secures it for the Trainers.
Central must do something.
Down pass there, the bar. She sets
up
again.
Oh, she turned around.
And she finally misses one of her threes.
Good rebound.
Newell with the big rebound. Barnes comes in and cleans the boards. Gustafson keeps hope alive with that big three.
Gustafson said, it's about time. Maybe that might get me started.
25-13 with 17-17 left in the second half. Little Smith. And she drops it in. Drops it in. Watch that one again. One more time. There's Gustafson. Lets it fly. Knocks it down.
You see the difference of that shot was she got to set her shoulders up. She got to square up her shoulders.
She squared it up and let it fly.
Yep. Got subs coming in.
Foul on Barnes as she checks out. She's not putting enough arc on that shot.
Straight shooters.
Yep. It's like Ricky Rubio out there.
Pollard.
There you go, Pollard. Good hustle, Pollard.
You know, one thing, I'm going to give her heart. Because she's been hustling out there.
Newell. You know what? Where are they getting these players from? Every year it seems like they got somebody new that just steps in and just, you know.
She's playing ball.
They're putting it to the Lady Minutemen.
Sheldon's out there having a good time.
Pollard, and she comes up short, no foul.
This game is looking like it's getting to be an early blowout in the second half.
Well, we got a 16-point lead by the Trainers.
And the shot. The miss. Over the back foul.
We got, well, wait, what's the call here? What's the call here? All right,
Fred,
all right.
We have fan appreciation.
Oh, okay. Well, that's what it is. All right, all right, all right.
You know, the beauty of these games is the turnout, you know. I mean, it's just lovely to see a lot of these people that we don't see too often. That's what I love about the alumni games.
All right, Gus was looking for an opening. She kicks it into Pollard. Pollard takes it up again, and she comes up short one more time.
Let me see. Pollard must be about 0 for.
Oh, she got one basket.
Okay, 1-4. I'm sorry about that. Uh-oh.
Hicks. And there's Suggs to clean up. Oh, she misses the putback. She took that one for granted. Nice pass.
That's what Central needs.
There you go. There you go. Nice pass.
Get back into this game. See how fast they move. See how slow Mechanic Arts move.
Yep, Gustafson to Walsh. They need about 10 more of those.
Uh-oh.
Whoa, whoa.
I'm not psychic here.
Suggs is shooting like the other Suggs.
Which one? Well, you know.
Pick one, pick one.
DeMar Suggs is
Walsh.
Her older brother.
Okay.
Ricky Suggs is
That's
her uncle.
Uncle. Pollard, oh, she just can't buy the basket today.
Newell. I'm liking Newell's game. Good pass.
Oh, way to look across court.
Uh-oh.
Suggs comes up short with that shot. Pollard's like, someone come help me out here.
Ah.
Good hustle.
Good
there we go. There
go,
Pollard. Good hustle. Good hustle on Pollard.
Oh, she's looking like alfalfa.
Well, good putback. 32-17. The Trainers over the Minutemen. Pick out Wims back into Suggs.
So unselfish.
Yes. So 3 seconds in there, too. No call. Dennings with coming up with the pressure. All right, let's see it one more time.
Pollard, who's been all over the place.
Now, what's a nice hustle there by Pollard. Good
that
effort,
was a
good
look
effort.
Like, that's it's about time.
Those things do happen. 12:35 left in the game. Barnes brings it up for the Trainers. She kicks it off to Higgs. Higgs lets it fly, and they're just going ballistic from three-point land.
Oh, man. What is that, five? That about five?
Well, no, they have more than that.
At least five this half, I mean.
Well, okay. 35-17. 18-point lead, and a Pollard with another miss. Demings goes up strong, and Higgs with the three-pointer. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
You know, one thing I like when that net sounds like that, it sounds like somebody saying, like it's a cough, and all you got to do is say, Kazinta.
It's got a little snap to it.
Yeah.
Kind of like a whip when it, like a little.
It's a.
All right, Neil Johnson's back in.
Okay.
And let's see. Wait a minute. They had six players on the court. Pollard. Hello. Oh, there you go. Maybe she moved further away from the basket. Maybe that's her problem. She's too close. Big basket by Pollard.
She's hot.
To get the mid back up to 19 points. Demings with the big rebound. They are just bullying them on the rebounds.
Oh. Well, she followed her shot.
Yes, she did.
Uh-oh.
Oof. Oh. All right, here it is. Pollard turns around and knocks it down.
I'm hot, she says. This is why I'm hot.
Well, you know, one thing they haven't been doing very well today, the Trainers, the shooting free throws. but I don't think it's a big factor right now in this game.
Have they been at the free throw line a lot?
Yeah, they've only made like one, I believe.
Okay.
One or two.
Demi.
And another.
Another swing and a miss.
All right, Central got the Greyhounds on it. Art Pollard.
Nice pass out.
Whoa, nice. You know, she got that young lady in the air. She should have leaned into her and let it fly. That's a foul.
Young man looked like he's a Central fan.
All right, Walsh controls it. Back over to Pollard. Pollard with the jumper. And it comes out. There goes Bad News Barnes.
Bad News Barnes.
More bad. Oh! Good hustle there by Gustafson.
No shit. See, if that's hurting them, not in letting Mechanic Eye set in their defense.
Johnson with the three, and that's off.
Uh-oh. Come on, hustle back.
Neil Johnson with the rebound over to Walsh. Oh, my goodness. Here comes the trainers, and they turn it over. They turn it over.
Layups.
Timeout on the floor by the trainers. And they have a commanding lead, 35-19.
Okay,
and there's a couple
fans.
Of, they're like, what's going on? That can't be the score.
That was that look like if I was out there, I'd probably have about 20.
Well, you know what? Central's not even using all their players on the bench either. I mean, sometimes you got to put some fresh bodies out there just to give your Greyhounds a break, you know. Two minutes.
You look at the score of the game. The year that was sports. 1994. Labor strike forces Major League Baseball to prematurely end the season, canceling the 1994 World Series.
Really? And at age 45, George Foreman becomes the oldest heavyweight champion in boxing history, defeating Michael Moore in 10 rounds. Who's Michael Moore, right?
I remember. Minnesota Golden Gopher women's basketball team beats Notre Dame to win their first NCAA tournament game in school history. That was in 1994.
Imagine that.
I remember that George Foreman fight. Michael Moore was winning that game, winning that fight, and George hit him with, like he was washing clothes.
Did he hit him with one of his grills?
One of his famous haymakers. Okay, minute, ladies. Minute, maids.
Denning back to Williams, back in the little. Just bit in. Little Smith. Oh, Williams with the long three and rolls up.
Look at Denning.
Denning's with the big board.
I'm going to tell you.
You know what?
Look at these guys laughing at him, man. That ain't fair. Don't be laughing at them. They can't make everything.
They can't get rebounds.
I'm going to tell you. Demings and Newell are the difference makers. They've been their hustlers. The young legs that's been helping Mechanic Arts out a lot this game.
And the clock is not on Central side either right now.
I'm tempted to sing my song. I don't want to sing it too early.
Man, there's another missed free throw.
But the lady could be in the back room warming up. La 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 la.
Wow. All right. Denny's with the second attempt. Oh, she'll hit this one. She got it. Oh, good hustle though. She almost had the rebound. Tim with the rebound for Central.
Uh-oh.
And they turn it back over.
Good pass.
Look at the reverse Demings. Layup, and Demings is back. Oh, no call.
The coach is looking up. What happened with the hand foul?
There's a shot.
Timms.
And she misses.
Jessica Williams. Littles Butler. Little Smith. Demi!
And one. They're going to count that?
He said no.
No
bucket?
Basket. Oh.
Did he say no bucket? Oh, on the floor? We need to talk to that. We need to talk to that man.
No. In it.
Yeah, let's look at that again. Oh,
we got the tail end, but I think that was a and one. Jessica Williams passes the ball, turns it over. Whoa! They're letting them play, and there's another three by Gustafson.
They are really letting them play. I mean, when you sacrifice your body like that, something has to be made. A call has to be made.
37-22 with 5:28 left in the game.
Williams.
She's off.
Oh.
All right. So she's going to make their run right now. Tim, they're going to make their run right here.
They're going to make their run where? Yeah. To the locker room?
No. No, they're going to get another basket here, and they're going to get a stop. All right. Gustafson brings it up, and she's looking for someone to pass it to. Neil Johnson. And she. Ooh. All right, there's another.
That's what we call shooter's touch.
Wait a minute. They only gave her, that was a three, wasn't it?
No, it was a two.
Oh, all right.
It was a two.
They cut it to 13 now.
They're on the run. Under 5 minutes to go in the game. Oh.
That's how you hit a killer rally. Here's that another shot, that shot again.
Just to tell you if it's a three here. Just inside.
Amber launches the three, but it.
Uh-oh, Demi. She's been everywhere.
Yes, she has.
She has been everywhere. Her and Newell.
Yeah, like they play like they've been around here for a while.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, they added a spark to Mechanic Arts. Not saying they didn't need one.
No, they've been a difference maker. And then, you know, Barnes got hot to start the second half. Because it would be probably a 6-point game if that hadn't happened.
Yeah. The difference in the game is the three-pointers.
And not the shooting from the charity stripe.
Did I say the three-pointers?
You're three-pointers, but.
No, the three-pointers.
Oh, okay. Because I'm going to tell you, they've made two free throws today.
You know, this
there's
is
the third one.
This is the sixth annual. And Central, in the last five, has not won a game. Mechanic Arts has made sure that Central knew that. And they asked before the game, are y'all going to win this year? And it doesn't look like it.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't look good right now with 2:56 left in the game.
So what we need to do, I got to say we because I'm a Central alumni. We need to regroup. We need to regroup.
Jones being pressured by Demings. She passes it inside. Oh. No 3 seconds call.
Hey, they better not call nothing now.
Yeah, Pollard, she's camping out down there. Oh, my goodness.
Hey, as I say, there's a lot of marshmallows roasted in the lane today.
Cross court pass. She got a hand on that, didn't she? Good defense by Walsh. And they score again. 26 points now for Central. 40-26 with 2 minutes left in the game.
Gustafson got hot in the second half.
Barnes kicks it back to the spin.
Well, here we go. Turn out the lights. The party's over.
Good tip. tip by Demings. It's knock her ball out of her hand. And I think Pirate, they're just going to just like.
Let's see that last shot there.
It's a fast break up the court. And a nice reverse layup there by Dustin.
Has done it all in the second half.
Well, yeah, I think, yeah, they pulled everybody.
Central really needs to regroup, find some fresh legs, some young legs too, you know, to really help out, and some height. Because yeah. I don't know what they can do.
Well, you know, at least Mechanic Arts, they do have a coach on their team, uh-huh. Debbie Williams. I mean, come on now. Who's coaching Central's team? One of the girls' boyfriends is over there trying to get things in order, but no. You need to have somebody work with you before this game if you want to make a game of it.
Okay.
But, you know, they got their heads up. All's not lost.
All six games in the sixth annual women's alumni game have been won by Mechanic Arts. Central had their shots. Not today.
Well, you know what? There's a minute 32 left. I hope they don't keep on shooting threes. They don't need to at this point. Just pass it around. Just pass the ball around.
Uh-oh, look who we have in the game now. We have the veterans in the game.
Oh, they do. They got
Deb Williams,
Curtis. Young Suggs.
Be careful.
And Higgs, so she wanted to do it. All right.
I say one thing, the referees
with the rebound.
Have let them play today.
And the way the day has been going, another turnover.
Central fans just don't understand what's going on, man. Trying to figure out, what do I need to do? Do I need to come out the stands is what the young lady is looking like now.
Well, is it clock?
Curtis
takes a shot.
Fast break.
She gonna let her have that one. Oh.
Look at Shelton. Sheldon had a good time. The Rodman Trot.
What's he called? Travel.
Oh. Kick her out the game. Well, Bernard.
I think that is it. We're in the 10 seconds. Higgs with the long three at the end of the game, and that is it, folks. This one's in the books, 40-26. The Trainers keep their streak alive to 6-0 now, 40-26. Tim, to sum it up briefly, what I don't know what to say.
I mean, this is one of the lowest scoring games this year. You know, 40-26, 26 points Central. No, we got to go back to the drawing board.
Yeah, they do.
We do. 26 points is not going to win a game for you.
Right.
You know, it's. And I'm getting a number one sign pointed at me from a Mechanic Arts. You know, this game was good. It was slow. It was slow paced. Second half was a lot better than the first half. But the Trainers, Mechanic Arts, they looked already like, you know what, we got this game. You know, and they played like it.
They had it pretty much in hand. Well, on the bright side, no one got hurt, so.
Yes.
We can look forward to seeing these ladies coming back next year. Maybe they'll break the streak next year, hopefully. But, ladies and gentlemen, coming up in 35 minutes is the big game between the Trainers and the Minutemen.
The 24th
annual basketball game. And they have a little streak going, too.
Yes, we do.
They've won six in a row. It's on the other side of the coin. Yeah. So. Until we meet again, this is Bernard Foster and my colleague here, Timmy Simmons. We'd like to thank you for joining us today. and peace.
Have a good evening.